So I made a mistake last class, and almost none of you caught it at the end. So everything was correct, except for the very pretty much the last thing I wrote that was significant. So this was all correct. What I recommend you do is write your actual interval directly below the number line. So like this shape right here is exactly how your interval is going to look. And if you write it directly below your actual number line, you hopefully will get the smaller value on the left, the bigger one on the right. I had before, I think I had 4/3 to positive infinity, basically opening the wrong direction. So the next thing we're going to talk about is just pretty much notation, and this is operations on functions, arithmetic operations on functions. So if you add two functions together, you can write it like this. Same thing with subtracting. It's fx minus g of x. Multiplication. We use a little dot, except multiplication is kind of dangerous because it looks a lot like function composition. Division, at least, doesn't look like anything else. This is composition. We'll look a lot more carefully at composition later. I'll try to make sure with composition that I always write the it's a dot between f and g. It's a empty dot. This will be f of x or f of g of x. So composition won't happen until much later. I think chapter 5 or so is where we do function composition. And now we're ready for the graph of the function. So we'll jump into the next section. Well, we kind of did function notation already. Oops, that was the wrong button. So we'll look at graphs of functions. So what is a graph of a function? It's going to be all points. The points are going to be an x coordinate and a y coordinate, and the y coordinate is going to be known as f of x. And this is when we get our function in the form y equals f of x. So the graph is all points x comma f of x such that the x's are in the domain of f. So this is the definition of a graph of a function. Really similar to the graph of an equation. It's all graph of an equation is all points that satisfy the equation. And we have a vertical line test. So graph is a function if it passes the vertical line test. So what does it look like to pass the vertical line test? So instead of talking about what does it look like to pass, we'll look at what does it look like to fail. So we know if there are two points that have the same x-coordinate and different y-coordinates, they will appear above and below each other, like this. So if we have two points like this, and let's say we have a x1, y1, and the other is x1, y2,